Professor Hughes, you put it into context that the United States has been sort of clear in recent memory in terms of identifying where they're going. And one of the areas has been around the challenges with the global economic balance of power, the impacts of the playing field and the rules around global trade, not the least of which is the rules at the WTO. And they have made motions that they want to amend some of those. Is that a fair statement?
That is a fair statement. The United States has become increasingly frustrated with some of the operations of the WTO. That is a fair statement. And just let me say, and I thank you for calling on me again, because I spoke so long last time, I thought you never would. But those who say, you know, the WTO is dead because the appellate process is suspended right now, I don't think that's fair either, right? We've really just reverted to the GATT system. The GATT system was a very constructive system for resolving trade disputes. But I'm optimistic, but we will go through a period of reassessment, I think all of us together.
And one of those is around the domestic procurement and how we would use domestic money for our own industries and national security elements, correct?
Absolutely. And I think to riff off something Ms. McCune would say, you know, those of us who believe in international trade, many of us also believe that localization is very important, and North American trade is more important than distant trade. And so we should be fostering that.
So fair enough. So we look, possibly we might have an option to open Chapter 13 of CAAM, or perhaps we can look at the possibility of WTO rules being changed. But as you've said, trade never operates in isolation, and some of the American policies are not directed necessarily at Canada, but the United States has been clear that there are some other aspects sort of outside of trade, from environment to security to defense, that they would like perhaps Canada's position to change, and that also might be a leverage point for our relationship on trade. Is that how you're seeing it as well?
Yes, but I think that the commonality of Canada and U.S.'s positions in multilateral fora is long and documented. I'm just reading a book on the development of GATT, and of all the members of the Commonwealth at the time of the development of GATT, it was Canada and the United States trying to convince all the other members of the Commonwealth to come along.
So should Canada be looking at reviewing our position with respect to WTO, with respect to some of the North American NORAD defense principles, with respect to, say, our relationship with some other, perhaps not like-minded countries, if we are hoping to reinvigorate bolster our relationship with the United States?
Well, I think that we need to find the common issues more than trade. We need to find the common things we care about: democracy and the environment and labor protection and human rights. And let me just say, just as 22nd, that everyone needs to understand that after World War II, the trade system threw all those things out in order to try to get the world economy started again. We're reaching a point now where it's time to bring those back in and say those count.
A balance between world trade and domestic national security capability, correct?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
And then, Ms. McCune, if I might, your organization published in February 21st, 2020, a document making some recommendations around what information Canadians should have around impact, economic impact, and you recommended that economic impact assessments should be mandatory within the parliamentary process. And I'm wondering if you still feel that way, and if understanding what the economic impact of a Buy America or exclusion from a Buy America process would help in terms of Canada's positioning on this topic.
Very quick answer, please.
Sure. I definitely think more transparency, more information, more consultation is always better. So, yes.
Thank you very much.